Hello my fiery friends, the Infernoman here with the hottest in budget deck technology. And for today's deck tech, join me once again as we play in this week's Midweek Magic event, and it's going to be based around the hottest new set that just came out last week, Outlaws of Thunder Junction Constructed. I decided we're going to be putting together a super awesome versatile deck that can go wide or go big, and it's going to be basically a scaled down version of last week's deck that we streamed, a deck that I am simply calling Outlaw Tokens. But before we continue, if you do like any of the content that I do, please like, follow, and subscribe wherever you watch the content so you don't miss out on any of the gameplay, booster pack openings, deck decks, and so much more. Long-time viewers of the channel know how we do it. We have to talk about the stats of the deck before we dive right into it. So, for our event deck this week, we're looking at Rakdos colors of black and red. We're looking at an average mana curve of about 1.8. We're rocking 16 creatures, 12 instants, 4 sorceries, 7 enchantments, and 21 lands. Now, if this deck looks a little bit familiar, we technically played an Explorer variant, of course, in the format when the set first dropped last week, but I'll be very honest with you, if you did get a chance to see the stream, it didn't really perform as well as I thought. So, fortunately, again, we have a second shot this week with the Midweek Magic event. So with that out of the way, let's talk about the creatures first in our deck, and then we'll work our way through the support. So, starting in the one-drop slot, you have Nezumi Linebreaker, and you have Restless Lackey. Both of them will help us do some early game damage with their simple little 1-1 pings, but of course, if the Linebreaker dies, it gets to create a Mercenary Creature token, which is great for us for what we're going to talk about in a bit. We also have Restless Lackey here, which is also great for the mid to late game, because you can sacrifice it for 3, then draw a card and create a treasure to kind of help us make sure we maintain our ramp ability. In the 2-drop slot, this is again where things get a lot more exciting for us. So we have Blood Hustler here and we have Vial Smasher. Talking first about Blood Hustler, this is a really awesome little card here that simply states, whenever you commit a crime, put a +1/+1 counter on Blood Hustler. This ability triggers only once each turn, and for 4 mana, target opponent loses 1 life and you gain 1 life. This is an awesome vampire rogue that'll help us, of course, commit crimes to trigger certain abilities that we have in the deck. We also have, as I just mentioned, Vial Smasher, Gleeful Grenadier. I actually forgot about this card last week, and I totally would have threw it into the original deck we played on stream, but let's talk about this super awesome card right here, right now. Vial Smasher, Gleeful Grenadier is a 2-mana, 3-2 Goblin Mercenary that reads, whenever another outlaw enters the battlefield under your control, Vial Smasher deals 1 damage to target opponent. Remember, for those of you who forgot, outlaws basically are anything that's a warlock, an assassin, mercenaries, pirates, or rogues. So this is super awesome because this will help us ping to commit more crimes and trigger off more of the abilities. But again, we'll talk about what we're trying to pay off with these cards in just a little bit. Going into the 4-drop slot, we only have a single card here, which is Hellspur Posse Boss, a 4-mana 2/4 lizard rogue that reads, other outlaws you control have haste, and when it enters the battlefield, you get to create 2 1/1 red mercenary creature tokens. Now, how exactly are we going to make the most out of all these outlaws that we have?
Good question!
Well, as always, I'm glad you asked. So, talking again, going back to the 1-drop slot, we have the Great Train Heist. If you saw me play this on stream, this is a really awesome card and a very powerful card that I definitely want a copy of in one of my future commander decks. But in any case, if you haven't seen it again, Great Train Heist is a 1-mana with plus, it's a spree card. That basically means that you pay the 1, but you'll also have to pay whatever it's required for the next part. So, if you cast the spree, then that means for 1 red, you can choose target opponent, where a creature you control deals combat damage to that player this turn, you create a tapped treasure token. Or you can pay 2 of any, and then creatures you control get +1/+0 and gain first strike until end of turn. Or you can play the 3 and untap all creatures you control, and if it's your combat phase, there's an additional combat phase after this phase. Of course, you can then pay any additional amounts in any mix and matches however you like, but the point basically is, this is going to be a really awesome flex card that can help us, again, just help close out the game, either helping us ramp, do some extra damage to beat down an opponent's game plan, or we can just do an extra combat phase just to then smash our way to victory. Also in the 1-drop slot, we have Quick Draw here, a simple little card here that's going to be great for us for a combat trick. It just simply allows us to give us a +1/+1 and give one of our creatures first strike until end of turn. We're also going to be utilizing in the 2-drop slot Mourner Surprise, a simple little sorcery that allows us to bring back one of our cards from the graveyard back to our hand, and also get to create a mercenary creature token for that deal. Shoot the Sheriff here is going to be your catch-all as removal against non-outlaw creatures. You also have Brimstone Roundup here. This is actually a really sweet little card, but we only need one copy of it, where it allows us to create another token as long as we cast our second spell each turn. So really help us just to kind of help create stuff if we can't target anything and commit crimes per se against our opponent. Caught in the Crossfire here is also pretty sweet for us, and actually can be a hilariously little sweet card if, again, we time it just right. A simple little spree card that allows us to cast for 3 mana where you can deal 2 damage to each outlaw creature or 2 damage to non-outlaw creatures. Ideally, you want to just use it either as a pseudo-wrath, or then you could just wrath yourself to then close out the game with our next card, which is Raggish Crew. Again, I utilized this one on stream last week, but again, for those of you who haven't seen it, it's simply kind of like Bastion of Remembrance, if you remember that card, where it just helps us create a token when it enters the battlefield, and anytime we outlaw, we control dies, our opponent gets pinged where they lose 1 life, and also we will gain 1 life. And then finally, our last card, Knife Point. Knife Point here just allows us to create some tokens as long as we are committing crimes along the way, and it only triggers off once each turn. However, with instant speed removal, this allows us to basically create at least 1 token each turn, whether it's our opponent's or it's our turn. As far as the lands are concerned, nothing again super fancy here is just going to be what we essentially need, which is the swamps and mountains down the middle. Jagged Barrens here will commit a crime because it does target our opponent when it enters the battlefield to ping our opponent for 1. And then finally, an Errant Archway here to bounce back ideally one of our deserts so we can then trigger off the surveil ability, and also we can trigger off the crime committing by pinging our opponent for 1 more time. The only reason why we have just a single copy is just to make it a little cheaper for us to say trigger off like a card, let's say like Blood Hustler. Now, if you're interested in taking this beyond, say, Midweek Magic and you want to take this into Standard, here's going to be, again, more or less how I'm going to explain this in the context of that format. So, of course, your biggest advantage with the deck is how versatile it is. Even with this limited card pool, this set actually does a really good job of providing us a really good versatile deck. And what I mean by that is, as you saw when I explained everything, you want to go as super wide as you can with all the tokens that you can make. However, when you have a card like Blood Hustler, that card can still build itself up, even if it's on its own, or if you have a bunch of tokens, start pinging out your opponent, and then you can start building that up as one giant threat. So you have the ability to go super wide or super big with this deck, depending on what your game plan and depending on how the board state looks. You have a lot of ways of grinding out your opponent with cards such as Reckless Lackey and Nozumi Linebreaker here. Vile Smasher, of course, is going to be key as it will continually keep pinging and then continually triggering off the crime committing ability that Blood Hustler and other cards such as At Knife Point need to get the most value out of them. Remember that again, you also can kind of pseudo combo off with Caught in the Crossfire, because if you do, say, label non-outlaws, you can blow up your own creatures, which may look a little goofy at first, but if you just need to close out your opponent and just beat them down, say you have a Rakdos Crew out, that can just close out the game as you just drain out your opponent on the spot. And then the only other final advantage you have is, remember that all of those mercenary creature tokens can be tapped to then give one of your other creatures a +1 boost, and say like if you have At Knife Point out or a quick draw, this can then give you also another buff with First Strike to your creatures, which can then force your opponent to do some bad blocking in order to put additional pressure and hopefully help you win the game. Of course, the biggest weakness that I'm going to mention to this deck is if you want to take it into something beyond Midweek Magic, you're going to be facing some decks that will have a lot of wraths, and some of those wraths even exile creatures, so that means Rakdos Crew will not give you its ability to trigger off because they will not die, your creatures will get exiled. So if you do end up taking this into a Standard, just be aware of that, so if you have to deal with those decks, you're going to have a bad time. But if you are interested in taking this, say, beyond just the Standard format, maybe you want to play it in Explorer, I definitely have, of course, a variant of this that I played on stream, as I mentioned earlier in the video, so be sure to check out the stream itself. I'm not going to obviously expect you all to just sit through 2 hours of that, because yes, there were some really awesome moments where the deck did go off, but it didn't quite perform. So we're going to probably look at this deck again in the future if you're interested in this kind of archetype. But having said all that, here are my final thoughts that I just want to give on the deck overall. Even though it is a limited card pool, I'm very surprised at the fact that Thunder Junction actually has just enough pieces to actually build a deck that I'm a really big fan of. If you've seen some of my other previous videos, I do a lot of token decks out there. I do love playing sacrifice decks out there and then grinding out your opponent. So to put it another way, if you are a fan of grindy style of decks, if you are a fan of versatile effects where you can then just outdo your opponent with a lot of sacrifice triggers and then making a bunch of tokens to go super wide or super big, definitely I would say give the deck a try. And I assure you, if you take this into Midweek Magic and then get your wins, you'll have a lot of fun doing so. You'll be very surprised at how quick it can pull off those victories. And actually, I would even say take this even into Standard. It's actually very, very fun to play. And I assure you, when you get your wins with it and beat down your opponent, you'll definitely not be disappointed. That's all I have for you today. Thanks again for watching, everyone, and just remember that no matter what you do play in the game of life, always be sure to burn bright. Later!